Agricultural practices are consistently evolving, and Africa is seeking ways of improving agricultural output to suit local and foreign demand. The Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology, like all higher education institutions in Ghana, aims at solving societal problems. Eventually, there was a need for the College of Agriculture and Renewable Natural Resources to set up the Department of Economics, Agribusiness and Extension. This unique and complete department aims at producing graduates who are equipped with complete knowledge on how to assist farmers from the pre-production, production, as well as post-production phases, all with the aim of getting Ghanaian produce on the foreign market under fair pricing. Most of the students from this department become entrepreneurs who elevate Ghana on the foreign.
Undergraduate requirement for BSc Agriculture is the same, I mean within the faculty, because it's a composite program. But we also run BSc in Agribusiness, okay, where I mean the requirements, basically we enroll students who have background in business. We also enroll students who have background in science. The employability rate is high. For instance, we have students who have finished agricultural economics, even at the BSc level, who have been employed by financial institutions like banks, okay? And then for agribusiness, we have students who join both government institutions and then also private institutions, okay? I mean, for instance, we have students who are working in private institutions like Blue Skies and the rest, where they produce all these agribusiness products. And then also, apart from that, we have students who have also joined international organizations and non-governmental organizations. So the employability rate is really high. What we have been doing is that we normally have seminars and we invite them to come and give their experiences. The alumni of the department, normally what we do is to invite them, when we have seminars. We run seminars for students here. So we invite them and then they come and share their experiences with us. And then also sometimes when we are doing fundraising, they also come and then contribute. They come and contribute to the success of most of the programs that we are doing here. Yeah, the yearly research output of this department is very high because we undertake a lot of research, both in agriculture, economics, agribusiness, and extension. And averagely, I can say that we produce about, say, 30 refi papers, okay, in high impact factor journal every year. The success series is that some of our journals, you know, if you are able to publish in these high impact factor journals, then the international community gets to know you. So this has attracted some funding where we have collaborated with we have collaborated with universities outside, okay, in the US, in the UK, where our students have benefited from these things that we have done. The department has effectively collaborated with the industry. In fact, that is one of our aims, okay, for bringing in this agribusiness program on board. So what we are trying to do right now is to inculcate the spirit of entrepreneurship, okay, into our students, okay, so that this kind of unemployment gap that we have in the system, can be bridged. So what we do is that we send our students, okay, on internships, okay, to well-noted private firms. And then also, we also send them on vacation training. And then, as I said earlier, when we are organizing seminars, okay, we bring the chief executives, okay, to meet our undergraduate students and then postgraduate students, and then they share experiences with our students here. So the link, with our department, with the industry, is very, very, very strong. The main institutions that we collaborate with are both internal or local and then international. And internally, I mean, this department, because now, I mean, the focus of the university now is to do some kind of interdisciplinary approach of doing our research. So we have collaborated with other departments like crops and then soil science departments, animal science department, horticulture department. And when it comes to other other universities in Ghana, we have also collaborated with universities, University of Ghana and the University of Development Studies. We have also done that with them. And then we also serve as external assessors, I mean, to these universities, okay, for their master's program and then PhD programs, okay. And then also, they also, I mean, in turn, also serve as external assessors to most of the students that we train here. And then for international, we have a collaborative research with a lot of universities in Germany, in Netherlands, in the UK, and then in South Africa and in Denmark, where, I mean, for instance, some of our teaching staff here, I mean, have been trained there. And then also we are able to get scholarship also for our students, I mean, who go there, I mean, to be trained, I mean, for their masters and then PhD. For instance, there is one program that we have, which was called a mobility scholarship, where we send master students, about three of them, to South Africa, okay, I mean, to complete their masters there, okay. And then also, I mean, I in particular, I've been collaborating with some professors in Germany where I send PhD students there. Okay, so, I mean, the collaborative thing for the international level is also very strong. Students are really engaged in this because, I mean, not on the undergraduate, but on the postgraduate level, I mean, students have been benefiting from all these projects and then the teamwork that we have been having with these universities. Let me point out that in the undergraduate level, I mean, this department happens to have the largest number of students for the agribusiness program. So, I mean, the average or the enrollment keeps on increasing year after year. So what we decided was that it will be appropriate for us to also link with the industry. There are a whole lot of people who are in the industry who also want to come and have their degrees. So we had the Agribusiness Management Program, I mean the MPhil or the MSc degree on the IDL platform, where we enroll more than 35 students. ICT has been integrated into our teaching and learning process in diverse form. I mean, for instance, currently we teach our students using PowerPoint presentations, and then also we also give them practical training on how to present their seminars using PowerPoints, okay, and the rest. And then in terms of extension services, okay, we teach our students how to design practical training materials and then manuals, okay, on computer. My advice to students, I mean prospective students who want to join our department, is that come in here and then study with us. I mean, their future is bright, because when they are able to go through their training here, the skills that they have acquired, they have opportunities of joining other financial institutions. They also have opportunities in joining both governmental and then non-governmental organizations, okay? And then also they can also join international organizations, okay? So in terms of agribusiness, for instance, they can join most of these private companies that are springing up, I mean, lately. Then also, I mean, our focus right now is to inculcate in our students the spirit of entrepreneurship. So we are training our students in such a way that when you finish school, it's like you don't have to depend on the government to employ you, but rather you can start up your own small businesses. So these are areas that we are trying to encourage our students that when they come, they have this opportunity. There is an opportunity for students to have their own private businesses if they intend to do that, after finishing school.